Are you interested in planning your Instagram content but have no clue where to start? Today, I'm sharing my top tips for compiling an Instagram content calendar to take the stress out of posting and get you more likes, followers, and comments. Hey YouTube, it's me, Brie. I'm a writer, playwright, editor, and writing consultant focused on helping other writers achieve their publishing dreams. If you're interested in learning more about writing, editing, publishing, and social media for authors, make sure you click that subscribe button and ding that bell so you never miss an upload. And stay tuned through the end of this video to find out how you can streamline your Instagram posting process. Before I had a content calendar, my Instagram was a mess. In terms of subject matter, my content was all over the place, I was inconsistent in terms of timing, and my calls to action were either infrequent, confusing, or both. I wasn't using the platform to its full potential, and my overall lack of engagement and conversion frustrated me. But once I started using a content calendar to schedule and plan out my Instagram posts, my engagement skyrocketed. Posting relevant photos at the same time every day kept people coming back for more. Crafting compelling captions that connected or converted led more and more people to reach out to me via DM, leave comments, and/or purchase my books or editing services. Creating and keeping a content calendar is the single best thing I have done as an author on Instagram to help boost my platform. When it comes to Instagram, you need to know what days you're going to post, what time you're going to post, and what the subject matter of each photo will be. Also, you should nail down the content of your caption. Some people recommend writing your captions way in advance, but for me, I tend to write my captions sometime the day that they go live. In an ideal world, I might write all of my captions way ahead of time, but right now, where I am at with my schedule and my workload, it's just not realistic for me. At the very least, you should know what topic you want the caption to cover so that you're not just rambling on about nothing or saying shit your audience doesn't care about. As far as what time of day you should be posting goes, this might be controversial, but it really doesn't matter as long as you're consistent. So many articles and resources try to recommend the best time of day to post, but when it comes right down to it, best is subjective. If you really want to get technical, you can upgrade your account to a business account and check your insights and analytics, but we're not going to cover that in this video. After all, it's really not necessary. The if you build it, they will come philosophy applies here as it does to a lot of other places. If you post every day at 3 o'clock p.m., your audience will know to expect content from you at around 3 o'clock p.m., and we'll come and check out your page around that time to see if you've posted anything new. When it comes to writing captions, there are a few things you need to keep in mind. First off, what are the pillars of your platform? I recommend picking three. For me, those are writing, publishing, and social media for authors. When I'm brainstorming content to create for Instagram, I try to make sure it falls into one of these or all of these three pillars. Another tip, if you are posting weekly, that is once a day for all 7 days of the week, I recommend you strive for 2 conversion posts and 5 connection posts. You can pitch your books, products, services, etc. all you want within reason as long as you make sure to balance those pitches with other relevant content your audience will enjoy. No one wants to open the app and see 1,000 sales pitches from you in their feed. Especially if you're just getting started on Instagram, no one gives a shit about what you're selling. They want to peek behind the curtain, get to know the person behind the product or business. You know, build a community. This is where the connection posts come in. Unlike conversion posts, which should include some kind of call to action, like click the link in my bio to do whatever, connection posts should just be about starting a conversation. I like to ask open-ended questions at the end of my connection posts, such as, what are you reading this week? This is a great way to get people talking and build some long-lasting relationships. Just make sure you're responding to the comments in a timely, meaningful, and thoughtful manner. The sooner you can respond to the comments too, the better, as far as the Instagram algorithm is concerned. Again, some people recommend planning content way in advance, say 1 to 2 months. For me, though, like with captions, that's just overkill. I got other shit to do. I sit down on Sunday night or Sunday afternoon and try to plan all of my Instagram content for the coming week. For me, that's what works, and that's more than enough. If I have time, I will also use this day to take as many photos in advance to match up with the captions I have planned as I can. Again, it all just depends on time time, then you should do whatever works best for you. If you're feeling motivated to plan your Instagram content after watching this video, click the link in my bio to sign up for my newsletter, where you will receive all kinds of great writing and social media related freebies, including my free printable Instagram content calendar. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you all next week. Bye!